We're in the week of the solstice, holiday time. I'm thinking of the lines, the familiar lines. All is calm, all is bright. Which may not necessarily be an actual description of how things feel. Everything outside is. All is calm, all is bright is the state that we're looking for in terms. Those are both descriptions of what sattva is, bright and lucid. So our work as we do our yoga practice is to try to find, locate those qualities within ourselves. They're there. Called Jyotishmati, the light that is without any suffering, the inner light, the internal light. We don't always feel it, but it is there. So we're going to work today with the pause, as we have been doing, taking a little moment after the end of the inhale and after the end of the exhale. Especially after the exhale gives a sense of stillness. And in those moments of pause, you can use either of those phrases or both of them, all is calm, all is bright, to try to identify those qualities inside yourself. We're also going to do some lifting, opening postures, and we're going to start by about the feeling of light, sunlight coming onto us, so which of course is an external experience, but we've all had it, and we're going to evoke that experience and then see to what degree we can find it. Even when there is no sunlight, and even when things are not necessarily very calm, how can we find that reality inside? All is calm, all is bright. We'll start at the back of the mat, finding samasthiti. Take a moment to check in with the feet, make sure you're well grounded. And then we're going to take the fingertips at the heart center, so go all the way down to the base of the sternum and make some contact, fingertips to the base of the sternum. Have that identified with your fingers, and you're sure that your feet are steady. Close the eyes. Soften the face. Watch the breath come in gently and out gently. Go back in your memory. So as we do the very first movement, which will be very simple, we're just going to open and close the arms. I want you to think of yourself as a receptacle for light, or receptacle of light. Receptacle is something that receives and then holds. So we're going to focus on the receiving part for a moment, and then feel if we can be a vessel for that light. Closed, if that's okay for you. Lips gently closed. Feeling your fingertips on the heart center. With a gentle inhale, float your arms out wide. Open them. Lift your chest a little bit. Lift your face a little bit. Pause briefly. And then as you exhale, slowly bring your fingertips back to touch the base of the sternum and soften the neck, the face, the shoulder. The arms out wide, open again. Try and let the chest lift and the face lift ever so slightly. Think of a flower opening to the sun. And with the exhale, let the fingertips come back and touch the heart center. If you tilted your face up, you can gently tilt it down. Soften the shoulders, take a small break. Drop the chin, soften the shoulders, pause for a moment. And relax the breath. Return to samasthiti for a moment with your eyes open. Having a sense of yourself as a receptacle of light. We're going to move into a forward bend. The poses that we do today, we're going to stay one, then two, then three, then four breaths in the pose. And always taking a little pause, both after the inhale and the exhale. Finding some space, and in that space, noticing the internal light or the internal calm. So we'll begin again with the fingertips at the heart center. Feel that space just at the bottom of the sternum. As we're moving here, you want to keep your eyes open. And float the arms out wide and go ahead and open the chest, gently open the throat, soften the face, pause. With your exhale, we bend forward, bring the hands behind the back, moving into uttanasana. Let your head hang, take a little pause, and then we'll stay for one breath. Inhale here, take a little pause. Lift up to the top. Flip the arms out wide, gently open the front body, receptive. And exhale, bring your fingertips back to the heart center. Pause. Second repetition. Inhale, flip the arms out wide. Feel open and receptive. Pause. Exhale, bend down, hands behind the back, letting the neck relax. Pause with the breath out, and this time we take two breaths, a slow inhale, followed by a little pause, and a complete exhale, and relax into the pause. We'll take another breath here, inhale, pause. And pause. Exhale the fingertips to the heart center. Pause for that stillness, that emptiness. Third repetition. Inhale, flip the arms wide. Pause. Exhale and fold forward, hands behind the back. Neck relaxed. We're staying for three whole breaths this time. Inhale. Pause and exhale. Pause. Inhale. All is bright. Pause. Exhale completely. Relax into the pause. All is calm. Exhale, fingertips to the heart center, and pause. Last repetition, we're going to stay for four breaths. Inhale, float the arms out wide. Exhale and fold down. And please count on your own 4 breaths. Include a pause after the inhale and the exhale. Think of the bhavana. Breaths. Lift on the inhale. And exhale, fingertips to the heart center. And relax the breath. Let your arms rest down by your sides. All is calm, still, quiet. All is light, bright, luminous. Let's move into Virabhadrasana. Put your hands on your hips to steady the pelvis and keep the hips still as you pivot on your right heel and turn the right toes out a little bit. And then step forward with your left foot. Put your feet well rooted down into the floor, and then we'll bring the fingertips to the heart center again. Simple Virabhadrasana, and we're going to stay 1, 2, 3, and 4 breaths. Staying with the pause. This is a back bend, so you've really got the chest lifted and open. Think of that feeling of bringing the light in and feeling what it's like to have light in the body. With the inhale, float the arms out wide and bend the left knee. Let your chest lift and your face lift gently. Stay here while you exhale. Take a pause and stay while you inhale. Pause, and then with the exhale, return the fingertips to the heart center, straighten the leg, let your chin drop down to gently stretch the back of the neck. Second repetition. Inhale, float the arms out wide, bend the front knee, lift and open the chest, the heart, the front body. 2 breaths, now we stay for exhale, and pause. And inhale. And with the exhale, fingertips return to the heart center. Chin drops down as the front leg straightens. And pause for a moment. Third time, inhale. Flip the arms out wide, bend the knee open and lift the front of the body. Stay for the exhale with the pause. And the inhale, lifting, opening even more, and pause. Again, exhale. And inhale. One more breath cycle. And exhale, bring the fingertips to the heart center, straighten the leg, drop your chin down, and pause. Last one, 4 breaths. Inhale, lift and open. And on your own, please count 4 breath cycles, which is going to be an exhale and an inhale 4 times. when you're finished, and exhale, return the fingertips to the heart. Let your chin drop down and gently stretch the back of the neck. Relax your shoulders and your face. And then release your arms and step that left foot back to join the right. Come into samasthiti and soften here. Let the breath breathe on its own for a moment. Return to the bhavana. All is calm. All is bright. Place your hands on your hips. Keep the pelvis still while you externally rotate the left leg. And then step the right foot forward. Root down through your feet. Get a good feeling of your connectedness down into the floor with both feet. And then bring the fingertips to the heart center. Stay with the pause. Stay with the connection of that internal sense of Sattva, Jyoti, Shmati. Inhale, take the arms wide, bend your front knee, lift and open your chest. You can tilt the head up a little bit and we'll stay for a breath. Exhale, the fingertips to the heart, the front leg straightens, drop the chin down, soften in the pause. Second time, inhale, float the arms wide, bend the front knee, open the chest, feel lifted and open, receiving, stay for your exhale, and pause. And take another breath like that. And with the exhale, we bring the fingertips to the heart center, drop the chin down, straighten the front leg, and pause. Third repetition. Inhale, float wide, open. Stay for three breaths. Exhale. Pause. And inhale. Pause. Two more breath cycles like that on your own. The exhale, fingertips to the heart center, chin dropping down, front leg straightening, take a pause. Last time, inhale, float the arms, bend the front knee, lift and open the chest. Stay for four breath cycles on your own count, starting with exhale. And use an exhale to close the heart, drop the chin and straighten the front leg. And as you're ready, return the right foot back into alignment with the left, find samasthiti. Relax the breath. You can close your eyes, bring your attention inward, whether the eyes are opened or closed. Breathe by itself. Attention resting at the heart center. So when we touch the base of the sternum, we're drawing our attention to the region of the body. But we shouldn't think that the heart center is sitting on the outside on the sternum. So as you bring your attention, let your attention move even more inward from there. Eyes are closed, open them up. Take Ardha Utkatasana. Four repetitions. We'll stay down one breath each time. Inhale, flip the arms forward and up. Then exhale, bend your knees and fold down. Relax your neck and shoulders. Touch your hands either to the floor or to your knees. Pause with the breath out, stay for one breath. So we stay for an inhale. Pause and an exhale. Pause. Then lift to the top on the inhale. Pause and exhale. Bring the arms down the front. Breath out. Three more times, just like that. Flip the arms forward and up. Exhale and bend down. And then release in the back of the neck. Pause with the breath out. And stay for one breath with pauses. And use an inhale to come to the top. Pause. And lower the arms down the front with the exhale. Pause with the breath out. Soften the shoulders. Third time. Inhale, raise the arms forward and up. Pause. And bend down with the exhale. Pause with the breath out. You can let that be as long as you want. Stay for a breath with pauses. And bring the arms down the front with the exhale. Pause a moment. Last time. Try one on your own. Awareness come to the heart center. We're going to move through a vinyasa, which has an upward facing dog in it. You may have noticed when we do back bends, like that here of Vajrasana, for example, Sometimes the breath doesn't stay quite as long. That's okay. Let it be smooth and stay with the pause. Even if the pause is just a moment, that will do. So you may find that that's the case here as we do the upward dog, that the breath might get a little shorter and the pause might not be very prolonged, but that's okay. And if the up dog is not suiting you, you can just do a hands and knees position instead. We won't stay anywhere here. We're just going to flow for a moment. So begin either sitting down on the heels or standing tall on the knees. Four times through this vinyasa. There's no staying except that little moment of pause. And we'll keep that little moment of pause going after inhale and exhale, trying to keep the heart lifted after the inhale, and a feeling of softness and surrendering after the exhale. With inhale, let the arms forward and up. Lift the chest, open the front of the throat. Exhale, bend all the way down to the floor. You're going to stretch your arms far out in front of you, child's pose, but really extend the arms. Then to up dog, inhale, sweep forward, drop your hips, lift your chest, pull your shoulders down, and pause a moment. Exhale, bring your hips back to your heels again. Pause with the breath out in child's pose. And then inhale, lift your arms, stand tall on the knees. Open the chest and the front body, pause, and exhale, lower your arms, and pause with the breath out. So again, if the up dog is too much for your back or shoulders, just go to hands and knees position. Let's do that three more times. Inhale, raise the arms forward and up, and open the chest. Exhale, and bend down. Extend the arms fully, pause. Press into the floor as you go into upward dog, hips down, chest up, shoulders down, pause, and then exhale, return to child's pose, pause, inhale, lift the arms, stretch up, open the chest, pause, and exhale, lower the arms. Sit down on the heels, and pause, twice more. Inhale, lift and open, pause, and exhale, bend down, pause, inhale, up dog, or hands and knees, and pause, exhale, back to child's pose, and pause, inhale, lift and open, and exhale, lower down. And pause. Last time, try it on your own. You're done. Take a moment to relax the breath. You can either sit on your feet, or if you want to tuck your toes under and stretch the bottom of the feet, that's a great thing to do. Or stand up tall on the knees, or if you need to be in child's pose, go ahead and do that. To go into a lunge, which is a pretty intense pose. So I'm going to give you an alternative. The lunge is tough on the knees particularly, but it's pretty challenging for the whole body. So if it doesn't seem to be the right thing, This is the alternative, and this is a good thing for everybody to do too. So let's just take one round with this alternative pose so you know what you can do if the lunge is too much. We're starting on hands and knees. And then we're going to inhale, stretch the right arm forward and the left leg back, trying to keep the torso as still as possible. And we're going to stay for our breath. So we stay here and exhale. Your gaze should be down at the floor. And stay while you inhale. And then with the exhale, bring your hand down and your knee down. And then to the other side. With the inhale, stretch the left arm forward, the right leg back. Try to keep your torso as still as possible. Gaze down towards the floor in front of you and stay for a breath with pauses. And it's an exhale that will bring your hand down and your knee down. And you can sit back on your heels again for a moment. So that's the alternative if the lunge doesn't seem to be the right thing for you today. Good idea while doing the lunge to take your mat and pull it back to double. It's underneath your knee. So go ahead and double fold your mat back and then stand on that extra padding. That will be helpful. So we're going to start by bringing the left foot forward and placing the left hand on the left knee where it will remain. So you're going to do the hands in all fours position. You're going to do the same pair, the right arm and the left leg, four times with us while we stay in the lunge. We're going to go in four times and stay for one breath. As you inhale, we'll take the right arm forward and up. And lunge forward on that left leg as far as it's comfortable to do. Open your chest and stay for a breath. That will be an exhale. And then exhale, lower your arm and back out of the lunge. And if you don't lunge forward on the leg, that's fine. You can just do the upper body. We'll do that three more times. Stay with the same side. If you're on hands and knees, you're going to raise the right arm and the left leg. Inhale. Move into the position, pause, stay with your exhale, and pause, and stay with your inhale, and pause, then exhale, move right away from the lunge, lower the arm, if you're on the horse, lower the hand and the leg, twice more. Right arm, parallel forward, lift your left leg, lunge forward, stay for a breath with pauses. Move that on the exhale, then pause. Last time on this side. Inhale into the lunge. For a breath with pauses. And exhale back away. Let's everybody go into a child pose for a moment. Relax the breath. Let the back release. Come back up. So you're going to come either to all fours or up standing on the knees again. This time we're going to bring the right foot forward and place the right hand on the right leg. on all fours, you're going to be lifting your left arm and your right leg. Inhale, raise the left arm, lunge forward or lift the right leg. Pause and stay for a breath. Exhale, pause and inhale, pause. Exhale, back away from the lunge. Let your chin drop down when your arm comes down. Take a gentle pause. Lunge or raise the left arm and right leg. Pause and stay for a breath with pauses. And back away on the exhale. Let your chin drop down, your shoulders relax. Pause twice more. Inhale, lunge forward. Pause, then stay for a breath. Back away with the exhale. And pause. Last time. Inhale forward. Raise your left arm and left right leg. And stay for a breath. And back away with the exhale. And we're all going to take Chakramakasana four times. No staying, but with pauses. Inhale, forward. Open the stomach, the body, and pause. Drop your tail between your legs, bend your elbows, relax your neck, move back. I'm going to really give the back lower back a nice stretch. Pause with the breath out. Inhale, come up onto all fours. Open the front body again and pause. And exhale, move back. Relax into the palms. All is calm. Twice more. Inhale, move forward and up and open. All is bright. Exhale. Relax into the hold after exhale. All is calm. One more time on your own. Then relax the breath. Take a moment here in the child's pose. The knees in for a moment. Close the eyes. Let the breath breathe by itself, including allowing any natural pauses. Soften the chest and soften the face. And push your feet down. We're going to do a pose that combines Supta Baddha Konasana, the reclined bound ankle pose, and Vipata Pedam. So we're going to be taking the knees and the arms wide and then lifting the hips up off the floor. If it's not comfortable to do both of those together, you could choose one or the other. You could either rest with your knees wide, just staying down on the floor, or you can take Vipata Pedam without opening the knees wide. We're going to stay 1, 2, 3, 4 breaths, so it'll be a little bit intense by the end. Make sure that you're still breathing smoothly and can pause. If not, you can take a variation. But try the first breath and see how it is. We'll start with the knees and the feet right in close to each other so they're touching. With the inhale, we're going to open the knees apart so the soles of the feet touch. The arms are going to come wide, like shoulder height, no higher. Then exhale, press your feet together and raise your hips up off of the mat. The exhale. And then exhale, lower down and close the knees. So you can choose one or the other. Inhale, take the knees wide, the arms wide, shoulder height, soles of the feet together. Exhale and raise the hips up off of the mat. And then exhale, lower down, and close the knees, let the arms come to the sides. Two more times. Inhale, take the knees and the arms wide, feel the heels touching into each other. Exhale, press up. The inhale with a pause. And an exhale with the pause. Again, inhale. Pause. And pause. One more breath. And lower with exhale. Inhale, open the arms and the knees. Press the heels together, exhale. Lift your hips up off of the floor. Pause and exhale. And exhale. Pause. 2.5 more breaths. Inhale. Pause. Exhale. Pause. Last full breath. And the final inhale. And use your exhale to come down, close the knees. Separate the feet. Relax the breath. Close the eyes. Attention inward as the breath breathes by itself for a moment. We're going to take a twist. We're just staying for four breaths, but you can extend the length of time by extending the pauses between the breaths, especially those pauses after exhale. So I think that the twist will feel good after that pose. Take advantage of your pauses after the breath so you don't have to come out too quickly. We'll stay, straighten the left leg out along the floor and bring the right knee into the chest. Take your right arm comfortably to the right side and then use an exhale to roll over, bringing your left knee towards the floor, your right knee on the floor towards the left. Pause with the breath out. And then start four breaths on your own. Maximize the pause, no strain, but let it be as long as it can comfortably be. Back onto your back and bring both knees into the chest. Relax your neck and shoulders and face. We'll put the right foot down, slide that right leg along the floor. Take your left arm comfortably out to the side. Use your right hand and exhale, slowly bring your left knee over towards the floor on the right side. And then you're on your own for four breath cycles, including whatever a comfortable long pause is. When you're ready, return to the back, put both knees into your chest. We're going to take up Uttanasana. So when I say a comfortable long pause, it's just what you can do without any effort. You just stop the movement of the breath and wait for the next phase to come in. So it shouldn't feel like you're building tension. It should feel like you're relaxing into that space. You don't need to count it. You just need to observe it and be sure that it feels comfortable and then let the next part of the breath come as it's ready. So with the inhale, let your knees float away from the chest a little bit. Open up your chest and your belly. Soften and wait. Just pause. And when the exhale is ready, pull the knees in close with the exhale. Get the breath moving out. Relax into this pause. Let it be. Several. Pause. Exhale, pull the knees in again. Again, take a comfortable pause, relax into the pause. Inhale, the knees float away. Just do three more of those on your own. Stretch out long in a comfortable position. Keep your feet as wide as your mat. Arms a little bit wider. Check in with your neck if you need to turn the head a couple times. Settle down into the position. Once you're comfortable, let your attention come to your breath. And watch it flow in and out. There may or may not be any pause. Just observe. You can stay with that bhavana, or let your attention come to your heart center. Thank you. be prepared to come away from the relaxation. Take a couple long, slow breaths. As you're ready, begin to slowly move your fingers and your toes. And then stretch yourself out long. Take a nice big breath as you stretch out. And then when you're ready, release the arms. Hug the knees if your back needs a little extra stretch. Now turn over slowly onto the right side with your knees in towards your chest. From here, we'll transition up into a seated position. We'll do a rather lengthy pranayama, a really complete pranayama. So make sure you get yourself comfortable up on your cushion or the edge of the seat of the chair. You want to feel the body supported and comfortable. The spine lifted so that the chest is open. There's space for the breath to be moving in the front of the body. We're working with the Langana pranayama. And we will gradually increase the length of the hold after exhale. And you may be surprised at how long it actually can become. If the number I'm suggesting is too long, then make it a bit shorter, of course. Don't create any strain here. The longer the hold after the exhale gets, the more sense of surrendering, relaxing into that space. We're using a gentle ujjayi breath, a whispered asana in the throat. So please take a couple rounds of ujjayi breath and establish a samana ratio between the inhale and the exhale. Make the inhale 6 and the exhale 6 as well. We'll start the pranayama. Inhale 6. And exhale 6. We'll hold the breath out comfortably for 6 counts. Again, inhale 6. And exhale. For 6. Inhale 6. Exhale 6. Hold the breath out for 6. Last one like this. Inhale for 6. Exhale for 6. Hold the breath out for 6. Inhale and exhale stay the same. We're going to increase the hold to 8. Inhale for 6. Exhale for 6. Hold the breath out for 8. Relax your shoulders and your face. Inhale for 6. Exhale for 6. Hold out for 8. Inhale. Out for 8. Last one at this level, inhale 6. Exhale 6. Hold out for 8. Next level, inhale for 6. Exhale for 6. We're going to increase the hold to 10. Inhale for 6. Exhale for 6. If the hold of 10 is too long, stay with 8. Exhale 6. Hold out for 10. Last one at this level, inhale 6. Exhale 6. Hold to 12. Inhale for 6. Exhale for 6. So there's some work in the belly, but really soften the shoulders. Hold the breath out for 12. Just settle into that count. For 6. Hold out for 12. Inhale 6. Exhale 6. Here, inhale 6. Exhale for six. Exhale for six, and we're decreasing the hold to just six now. And once again, okay, six. Exhale for six. Hold out for six. Now two more breaths with no hold. Inhale, six. Exhale, six. No hold. One more time like that. Inhale, six. And exhale, six. And then relax the breath. Inward focus for a minute or two. All is calm, all is bright. May this sense of inward calm, inward brightness stay with you for the next couple of weeks as we move through whatever holiday celebrations are happening or not happening. Remember, you can turn to this place in yourself, and you also can make use of that pranayama if you need to be able. Slowly open your eyes. Namaste. Thank you. will be January 2nd. All the classes in Rensselaerville are on their regular schedule this week, so there will be yoga on Thursday and Pilates on Saturday. And this is for all of you. Thursday evening, the solstice,